You won't believe what I found, Maggie. The Central Island and the five rock spires around it aren't just connected by underwater trams. There are also light bridges leading from the spires to this amazingly transparent crystal above the center island.
A bridge made from light?
I know, it doesn't make any sense, but it's true.
Their technology is so far advanced beyond ours that I don't know if anything could surprise me now.
If they can make bridges out of light, you have to wonder if they can make anything else.
Light.
You mean light beer?
Oh.
I was thinking more of a lighthouse. Light-minded.
Delighted.
Light-minded.
Light-hearted.
Light summer clothing.
Light-hearted.
Light summer clothing.
Light salad dressing.
Light-minded.
Light salad dressing.
Light-footed.
Delighted.
Light summer clothing.
Light salad dressing.
I never would have found out anything from the map room if there hadn't been all those engraved keys lying around. Almost as if they were left for us.
Only intelligent beings would have been able to figure out how to use them.
Maggie, that's the sweetest thing you've ever said to me.
I meant any being over the intellectual level of, say, a baboon.
Oh, now you're making me blush. When I called you before you were kidnapped, I was trying to tell you that it worked. I revived the alien.
Was it angry? Glad?
He didn't kill me, if that's what you mean. He talked to me, but I didn't understand anything he said. Maggie, we've got to find a way to communicate with the alien inventor.
I know, Boston. He's the only one who can answer our questions.
He's also the only one who knows for sure how to get us home. Thanks. Robbins. I don't know about you, but I'm starting to get tired. I've done a lot of digging.
And I've done so much reading, my eyes ache.
You still hanging in there?
I'm okay, Boston. Don't worry about me.
Thanks. Robbins.
Aye.
Never mind. looks like a panel. It won't do anything.
Here's where my alien education either pays off or we die.
Die?
As long as I don't accidentally offend him, we'll be okay.
Aklash Park.
He says, open your mouth, which is their way of saying, speak.
You do the talking, Maggie, so you can understand each other.
Speak.
Why was your tomb so carefully hidden?
So only the most persistent, the most clever, and therefore the most dangerous of visitors would find me.
What are the ghosts we saw? Are they alive?
My people all traveled to the realm of Space-Time 6, where three dimensions of time join to the three dimensions of space. It is indescribably beautiful. But they can build nothing there. They can create nothing. They just exist. On and on with empty lives and hearts that long for this hard and stony world.
The ghosts are your people, then.
Their connection to this world is so slight. They can disturb the energy in the air. They can make themselves visible for a few moments. But they can't build anything here. They will live forever. But it is not life.
Is it impossible for your people to come back?
It takes enormous strength of will to leave that place and come back to this one. They have all tried. They have all failed. And now they have been away too long. They have lost the physical memory of how to live here in Space-Time 4.
Why did the ghost lead us to you?
Some of them foolishly hope that if I help you open the gateway again, you might have the strength to lead them home, to let them remake their bodies here. But I am sure that all that would happen is you, too, would be lost in Space-Time 6.
The metal plates we found, what are they?
They are authority and power. Each shape has a meaning. And when they are fitted together, they have a new meaning.
If we put the control plates in the triangle, what will happen?
You will open the door to beauty without boundaries, and to trouble without end.
Did you invent the life crystals? To raise the dead is the greatest achievement we've seen.
What raises the dead can debase the living.
Are there side effects to the crystals?
What the crystals create is not a life. A slave.
So when the life crystals restore you, you aren't really alive?
They restore the cells and the organs, but take away all that made the life worth living.
Then why did you make them?
Our society became obsessed with living eternally. I underestimated the breadth and danger of the obsession. The crystals are the second worst mistake I made.
Why is this inscription in another kind of writing?
I did not write it. I would not have written it.
I can read it, but the meaning isn't clear. It speaks of something hidden.
It was the first achievement on the road to my greatest error. The one that condemned my people.
The language of the library was a great achievement. It was so clear and surprisingly easy to learn.
The greater the idea, the simpler and clearer the language needed to express it.
The light bridges are magnificent. We never dreamed that people could walk on light.
Ah, yes. We were happily surprised at how convenient those light strands turned out to be. If we had known, we would not have bothered to build the trams.
If you were surprised that the lights could be used as bridges, what did you create them for?
When all the bridges are complete, the eye will see.
When you say the eye will see, you aren't talking about our eyes, are you?
An eye that can see the three dimensions of time, as well as the three dimensions of space. It will show you beauty beyond belief. But once you have seen Space-Time 6, will you ever see Space-Time 4 again? The eye may be open, but the mind hasn't the strength to see.
The map helped us find you. Did you create it?
It was created by those who now wish only to find themselves.
Who are you, Honored One?
The bringer of misfortune.
Please, tell me who you are.
I am the doer who undoes, the creator who uncreates. And yet, I would gladly be the destroyer who undestroys, the dangerous one who protects.
Speak plainly. Tell us who you are.
Once, I was hailed as the greatest mind my people ever produced. I tried to bring them power and happiness. I gave them power to leave this world, to leave their bodies, to enter an existence as pure mind, eternally perfect. But I could not give them the power to return and reclaim their abandoned bodies, their decaying world. They are lost and cannot return.
Have you a name?
I had a name when I was alive. Now that I am again and again dead, what need have I for names? My body is now so ancient that the crystals scarcely have power over me. I rise for a few minutes, and then I fall again. Soon, I will cease to rise at all. Only then will my grief end. I want no name or memory to live after me.
The creatures who live here now, did you people know of them, or did they come later?
Millions of years have passed since then. What once were pets or companions have followed their own evolutionary paths. They have become as beautiful or as terrible, as clever or as stupid as it was in them to be.
The monster who captured me, are there any more of them?
That one did not evolve. It was made. And there are as many of them as are needed.
There's water everywhere in these islands. Waterfalls, pools, and the sea all around.
We love the water. But now my people live in an eternal desert, neither drinking nor thirsting. If only they could thirst again, and then drink. If only they could dive into the sea and hear the roaring of the waterfall.
We want to go home.
That is the wish of all living creatures. It is a vain wish, for there is no true home. All intelligence wanders and has no rest.
The probe you sent out brought us here. We want to go back to our home planet.
Another one of our terrible mistakes. We sent out those probes when we thought we had found the glorious secrets of the universe. We could not call them back. Thus, I remain here to warn all those who come in answer to an invitation we wish we had not sent.
Warning us won't do any good unless we can get back home to Earth to tell other humans.
There are two ways to protect your planet. One is if you return and warn them to stay away. The other is if you never return at all. Which warning do you think will be more effective?
Tell us how to get back to Earth. I beg you.
If my people could return from Space-Time 6 where they have gone, they would rebuild the starport. They would make a crystal ship which would take you back to your planet. But they will never find their way back home.
Why has your body been preserved so carefully?
Since all the evil in this place was my fault, I chose to be its guardian forever.
If what you did was bad, why do the museum displays give you so much honor?
There was a time when my creations were thought to be good. I believed it myself, or I would never have created them.
How long will you remain here?
Until the last of my mistakes is rectified, or until the life crystals lose their power out of miserable death.
How long will you remain here?
Until the last of my mistakes is rectified, or until the life crystals lose their power out of miserable death.
Thank you for helping us.
I will only have helped you when you give up your foolish plan.
We're not giving up.
My only consolation is that true death comes closer with each dying.
Good job of translating, Maggie.
He speaks very slowly and clearly. But I'm also pretty damn good.
This stone is some sort of trigger. It's jammed. I can't get it out. What kind of contraption has Brink made here? Robbins. As worried as I am for Brink, I can't help feeling a little angry at him.
He's wacko, nuts, out of his mind with greed. He's not himself. It's those damn crystals.
Thanks. Brink. verge of opening a gateway in the fabric of reality. If it works, we think it might lead us home.
Yes, you and Maggie can go home. Do you think I don't know you secretly plan to leave me behind and take credit for everything yourselves?
Brink, I have to tell you, you're exhibiting signs of advanced dementia. You're paranoid, violent, and manic.
I know you're saying these things to try to gain power over me. And if you don't shut your mouth, I'll shut it for you.
Why do I bother? Talking to you is a waste of time.
Då är det ju ett vattengrönt riset. Då är det inte så mycket kvar.
Shallow indentations. Yeah, right. Like I'm gonna stick my hand in some crack in the rock on an alien planet. It's a rod, engraved, five geometric shapes. Robins. Never mind. There's a signal here, but I'm not getting a clear reading. Can you look at this inscription, Maggie? Does it say anything that might help?
It wasn't clear to me before, but now I can see. Boston, it exactly describes that strange field of almost light.
What does it say?
It's a set of instructions. Now it makes perfect sense. I just twist this